Hello, and welcome to this very special episode of Creepy Cryptid Nation. It was a year ago today that I started this channel, exploring the unexplained and mysterious, from cryptids to extraterrestrials. It has been a fun and interesting journey exploring and researching these stories, and today we toast the first of hopefully many more to come. And of course, a very special thanks to you, the viewer who continue to inspire me to make these videos. Edgar Allan Poe, undoubtedly the greatest writer of the 19th century. Among some of his best works are Annabel Lee, The Fall of the House of Usher, The Pit and the Pendulum, The Telltale Heart, and of course, his most popular, well-known story, The Raven. Poe himself could not have written a better mystery that would happen years after his passing, and the loyal person who visited his grave on the anniversary of his death. Today, we look at the Poe Toaster. On October 3rd, 1849, Poe was found in a state of deliriousness in Ryan's Tavern, unkempt, in distress, wearing clothes that weren't his, and wasn't conscious enough to explain where he got them. He was taken to Washington College Hospital. During his stay, he kept asking for Reynolds, who still remains unknown to this day. He would pass away 4 days later on October 7th at the age of 40. No cause of death was ever determined. His death certificate lost, if there ever was one. Speculation has ranged from suicide to murder. The following day he would be buried, with little under 10 people attending the funeral. 1949 marked the 100th anniversary of Poe's death. In the early morning hours, people reported seeing a person dressed in a black coat, scarf, hood or hat covering his face, and walked with a cane. This person entered the site of Poe's original burial site at Westminster Hall and approached his commemorative headstone. He poured a glass of cognac and toasted the late writer. Before he left, he placed three roses at the foot of the monument, then left. It's believed the roses represented Poe, Virginia, his wife, and Virginia's mother, Maria Clem, while the cognac represented tradition of the Toaster's family. The bottles left behind were taken to Edgar Allan Poe's house and museum in Baltimore. For nearly 50 years, the Toaster would continue to visit the marker every year on the writer's death. He would continue to leave roses and a glass of cognac, along with some notes, the more famous of those being, "Edgar, I haven't forgotten you." A picture was taken of him and published in 1990 in an issue of Life magazine. One note left behind in 1993 stated, "The torch will be passed." This would later be confirmed in another note left in 1999, saying the previous toaster had passed away and the tradition was being handed down to their son. Those who witnessed the toaster in 1999 recalled them being younger. Before Super Bowl 35, to which the New York Giants would face the Baltimore Ravens, a note was left by the Toaster that read, "The New York Giants, darkness and decay, and the big blue hole dominion over all, the Baltimore Ravens, 1,000 injuries they will suffer, Edgar Allan Poe evermore. This was the first time that a current event of any kind had been mentioned. Despite the ominous note, the Baltimore Ravens would win their first championship, winning 34-7.
The sacred memory of Poe and his final resting place is no place for French cognac. With great reluctance, but for respect for family traditions, the cognac is placed. The memory of Poe shall live on evermore.
This note was in response to France's opposition of the Iraq War. Former curator of the Poe House and Museum, Jeff Jerome, believes the second toaster didn't take the traditionally as seriously as the previous toaster had. The toaster had been seen in regular street clothes on a couple of occasions. Sam Poporia would step forward in 2007, claiming that he began the tradition of the Poe Toaster. He would go on to say he started it in 1960s as a promotional idea. He would later state he started in 1949, also saying he wasn't the one visiting the headstone and that someone else was, but didn't know who. Jerome has discredited the Papora as the toaster, saying, "There are holes so big in Sam's story you could drive a Mack truck through them." Even Sam's daughter doesn't believe her father was the Poe Toaster. In 2009, the toaster made his annual visit to the writer's headstone on the 200th anniversary of Poe's birth. Unlike in previous years, those who came to see him, the turnout was small. The toaster poured the glass of cognac, placed the roses by the stone, and left, never to be seen again. This time, he left no note during his visit. The following year, he didn't return. This marked the first year that the toaster didn't make an appearance on the anniversary. Jerome has come to believe that the 200th anniversary was the perfect and logical stopping point for the toaster.
"I would have thought they'd leave a note for me saying it was over. That does annoy me a little bit, but they are under no obligation to do so,"
he would later say. Since 2011, there have been numerous imposters trying to continue the tradition. Jerome has confirmed that none of these are the original toaster, saying that he had been watching the toaster since 1976, and they gave a gesture, one only he knew. The Maryland Historical Society hosted a contest in 2015 to select a new toaster, to continue on where the previous toaster left off. A person was selected, and much like his predecessor, his identity was also anonymous. On January 16, 2016, the new toaster made his debut 3 days before Poe's birthday, wearing what the original toaster wore, but visiting the grave in the daytime. He would carry a violin playing Saint Saint's Dance Macabre before pouring cognac and placing the roses on the stone, then singing, "Glory paid to one's ashes comes too late," before leaving. Who was the Poe Toaster? A relative paying their respects every year on Poe's birthday, or a dedicated friend toasting to their late pal? Maybe it was a guilty party, someone who is involved with Poe's death and every year visits his grave as their penance. Or could it be Joe Jerome? Some have accused him of being the toaster, but he has always denied this. Whoever they were, they will fondly be remembered and won't be forgotten by the city and its people for many years to come. I'm Creepy the Cryptid, and I hope you will join me next time for another episode. And remember to look around the corner, because you never know what's lurking in the darkness.
Thank you.